a long time forgotten. Our dreams had just fell by the way. And the good life he promised ain't what she's living today. But she never complains of the bad times or bad things he's done, Lord. She just talks about the good times they've had and all the good times to come. She's a good-hearted woman in love with a good-timing man. She loves him in spite of his ways that she don't understand. Through teardrops and laughter they'll pass through this world hand in hand. A good-hearted woman loving her good time and man. He likes the nightlife, bright lights and good time and friends.
Hello and welcome to Sugar in the City. For those of you all who don't know, my name is Tanya and I am interviewing Mike and Katie Murowski. Mike is, among all things, the executive director of Upspring, and he has just recently thrown his hat in the pot to be Cincinnati School Board, right? That's right. And Katie is a receptionist at Desky Branding Firm, and she is awesome.
Hey, buddy.
Do you want to start? Yeah. You want Biggie to start?
So we have a mutual friend who was a coworker of Mike's when he was at Muller High School.
Okay.
Hi, sweetie. And Mike was getting ready to open up a nonprofit coffee shop called Choices Cafe.
Okay.
Close to the corner of 15th and Elm Street and over the Rhine.
You said that was a high school?
Mm-hmm.
At Muller High School. And you just opened that, right?
2008.
Yeah. Okay.
2008.
Okay.
So February 2nd, 2008 was the grand opening
okay.
day.
Wonderful.
And this friend of ours, Jim, invited me to go because he knew that through Xavier University, I had spent a semester living in Over the Rhine. I worked at an all-girls high school at the time that was very closely connected to Muller. And this friend, Jim, also thought I would really, really like the guy opening up Choices
okay.
Cafe.
Okay. Okay.
And so I went and I met Mike and immediately was smitten.
Oh,
oh no.
If you would say.
That's
just thought he was a really awesome guy with great priorities,
okay.
trying to do really, really wonderful things with his students and in a neighborhood for which I had a lot of love. So
okay.
on Monday, I emailed him because I wanted to get my students involved and also really wanted to hang out with him a little bit more.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
That's great. So were you looking for love at the time?
I was open to looking
okay.
for love.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
But
and how did you receive it, Mike? you received the email.
That's funny.
And then.
Yeah. So I was not open to love at the time.
No
in
way.
Fact, in fact, I had a pretty decent sized wall built around that part of my heart.
Because of
the past and being burned, and I had made a decision.
Is she gone?
Sort of dedicate myself full-time to fighting injustices. And so this time I've been 7 years in of working in Over the Rhine as a community organizer,
okay.
working on affordable housing projects. And so I decided, I said, you know what, relationships, interpersonal relationships don't work for me. My cause is fighting the system and changing the system, and I have to do that alone. I had this like righteous sense of
yes.
I have to go it alone and nobody can help me do it.
Oh gosh.
And Katie emailed me and I hung out. I was like, she's really cool.
Uh-huh.
And my Katie sort of like messed up my plans a little
oh,
bit.
No.
But
yeah, right.
but I kept fighting it like a dummy.
Did you really?
I did. Mike? I did. And my family told me I was a dummy. Mike Rogers told me I was a dummy.
Dummy because you didn't want to receive it.
Because I wasn't
you
receiving
were.
It.
Okay.
And
so, but what was that thing about Katie that kept you there?
She's
me.
Awesome. If you met her, me, well, she's persistent.
So I was persistent. And
you were?
So
and
he,
she's awesome.
He, you know, we broke up a couple times. Nothing overly dramatic or
yes.
anything. Just a good conversation about what he was looking for, what I was looking for. But I was insistent that we remain friends. And
wow.
so I kept showing up at the Gaslight Cafe.
No way, Katie. That is awesome.
Made sure we still hung out.
Okay.
And
Katie said something that was really points to what I was so attracted to with Katie, and what I'm still extremely attracted to with Katie, is that there was no drama in any of these breakups or anything. And like, I'm a fairly dramatic person.
Yeah. What do you mean?
Pretty melodramatic. Okay. Everything's a big deal, right? I wake up in the morning and I feel like Batman.
Okay.
You know, I do. And I think people that know me know
and
that.
I think I was drawn to you because of that too. I'm like, this guy is everywhere. So I'm like, I like him. Okay.
And I am everywhere, and I don't slow down. And Katie gives me perspective. She slows me down. There isn't drama. She believes in the same things, but she has a perspective of approaching the same sense of injustice that I feel like I'm called to fight. And she has the same call, and she has a different way of going about it. And together, it's just, yeah. And I finally realized I was being a dummy.
Oh, how long did it take you? How long did you date?
So we probably started dating in the fall of 2008.
Okay.
You know, broke up couple times, and then by the summer of 2011 is when we really got back together.
Wow.
And then he proposed
in November.
November of 2011.
It was a fairly quick turnaround because I there was no reason. I didn't need to think about it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I knew it the whole time.
How did you come back together in 2011? Was it just, oh, I'm going to call him, or did you run into each other and it sparked an emotion, or?
Yeah, kind of. It was at the Southgate House?
It was at the Southgate House.
Yeah.
And there was an event at Choices for a few graduating students. I had the event, and Katie was down at the Southgate House with some friends, and went down, and then Katie and I left together, and I'm going to stop the story there.
Okay. Okay, so you connected.
And so, yeah, we reconnected.
Yeah.
And then you said, this is it. The walls are down.
It was, yeah, and I knew it the whole time, yeah. Tanya. I was just like, again, I was like fighting something that was pointless to fight.
She was good for you.
Because I had made a decision that I was, this is what it was going to be. And when I make decisions, as I think you know,
yes,
I do it.
Yes. Okay.
And then, Katie's the best decision I ever made, though.
Yeah.
So. That is awesome.
Yeah. So Labor Day of 2011,
it's true.
The year before we were married, we were sitting right out there. Was listening to music, hanging
John
out
Mayer.
After, you know, we had a big party, lots of family and friends in for the fireworks. And I just laid it down. I'm like, do you want to marry me?
Wow.
Is this what we're doing?
And did you say yes?
I said yeah.
Yeah.
Is that good?
That's wonderful. And so, and I love the way you love each other. And I was asking about your history because I like to know the family history. And you all have a solid foundation, so can you share with us your parents' relationships, each of you?
Yeah. My parents have been married for 43 years, always lived in this, I guess they're still in the house that we moved into when I was about two.
Okay, so 43 years, yeah. And Mike, your parents have been married?
50 years.
50 years, so they have 93 years together.
Yep,
have a solid foundation. So you know what a marriage look like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Looks like, and you vow to not leave until this thing is over.
Absolutely.
Right?
Oh yeah.
Right? I think that you all have every one of these. I'm just going to ask you. So I have a book by Gary Chapman called The Five Love Languages. Are you familiar with that?
Mm-mm.
The five love languages are ways to keep your love tank full. And so these five love languages are words of affirmation, right? Encouraging words,
sure.
Words that lift your mate up. Words of affirmation, quality time, receiving gifts, acts of service, and physical touch. I've seen you do all five of them since I've been here. But I want to know, do you know Katie's greatest love language? Do you speak her love language? Do you know your love language from just this small session?
Mm. Do I know Katie's love? What are the five again?
Katie, you write it down.
If I'm
we'll
picking.
See if he got, this is
well, yeah, so
you write it down and don't let Mike
see. Say them again.
Okay. Words of affirmation, acts of service, cleaning around the house, keeping diggy, or physical touch. What is the one that you...
For Katie?
for Katie.
No, no, no.
Katie's.
Okay. Oh, what is mine?
What is yours? Because I want to know if Mike knows your love language. I think he does, but I like this game.
I think I do. I feel like this is like a game show. So
I
know
what
I'm going to say. I know what I'm going to say, but obviously I should let you write it down.
Okay, words of affirmation, quality time.
Receiving gifts.
Acts of service.
Physical touch.
Once she starts writing, I'll say it. Because then we know she can't mess. She can't, like, once she starts.
Gosh, is this, like, really difficult?
It's super difficult. There's a few, though, that are, I think, out.
Yeah.
There's a few that are out?
I think.
Okay.
I mean, they're all good, but, like, as far as Katie's top.
Yes. It's okay.
I'm sorry, Biggie.
Biggie, what's your favorite? What's your love language?
Physical touch.
Yeah, it absolutely is. Are you writing them?
Yeah.
So if we get this wrong, do we get in trouble?
Yeah.
Yes, we get a pillow.
Quality time.
What'd you write, Katie? Let's see.
Affirmation. I wrote words of affirmation.
That's the two I had.
Yeah.
You said quality time.
Quality time.
And you think quality time is hers. And why did you not say quality time?
I think because make sure we have lots of quality time together. We are both, like, super comfortable when, like, we're always in different places a lot of times.
Yes.
And so we really value that quality time. Like, we love to spend, like, usually at least an hour together in the morning just talking about our day, what's going on.
Okay.
And then at night, you know, when we can. It is really important to both of us. Yeah.
And I was going to ask you, because I know you both are super busy, what do you do for quality? How do you carve that time out to be with each other? Mm. Is it arranged on the calendar? Or like you said, is it that hour in the morning?
Yeah. A lot of it is, you know, that morning time. You know, we both wake up early.
Okay.
And so we do just make sure we have that. And if we have a busy week, we know, like, okay, Friday night, we are not doing anything. We are hanging out.
We do put it on the calendar.
Okay.
We'll put it on the calendar, like, don't do anything.
Right.
Yeah. And we plan ahead. We take little trips every now and then.
Okay. But you said words of affirmation is your top. So you receive what he does. Does he give it to you enough? Because he's like, go, Katie. And I'm like, that's wonderful.
So now that I'm thinking of it, I almost think that words of affirmation is your love language.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Because, and maybe that was like a, I don't know, subconscious thing for me to write down, but he's always, you know, just so, it is you. You're so affirming of...
So I do it
of everyone and everything and me, and it's I find myself doing more words of affirmation because of you.
Mm. Oh, good.
This is very interesting.
That's good.
You're always, you know, thanks for doing this, and all those little things that we thank each other for. I think I learned that from you.
Oh,
you know, thanks for taking out the trash. Thanks for taking care of Biggie today.
And you brought this gush of fresh air into his life. You're not dramatic, right? And so he's like,
true.
It's all good.
I love it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's so peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so I make sure that I thank him and affirm him more because I see him doing that so often.
Okay.
For me. Yeah.
Oh.
I think that's what that is.
So that's what that is? So you still like quality time?
It's okay.
It's fine.
Yeah. It's okay.
Whatever.
Any of any trials? It looks perfect to me.
And I think it is, but there certainly are. I mean, I'll speak for myself. I'm my own best and worst critic, and I like to point fingers at myself before I point anyone else. I could certainly work at always like saying exactly what I'm feeling in any given moment. For every, I don't always do that. And I'll hold it up. And Katie, the other thing about Katie, that she's the only person alive that can do this, and that's not hyperbole. Again, I am melodramatic. I get it, but this is totally true. Katie's the only person alive that can call my shit out when I'm being coy and I'm not saying how I really feel and doesn't make me mad. And when she calls me, and she'll call me out and go like, what the hell's your problem? And I'd be like, nothing. She goes, something's problem. And I'd be like, you're right. My problem is this. And it's either, sometimes it's silly, but sometimes it's significant. Yes. But that's just something I've always had to kind of work on. Right. On the interpersonal stuff, I got no problem telling everybody, their brother and sister, what I think about everything.
Exactly.
Nothing. I will tell. Yeah. Hey, it got me fired once, right? Like, I'll tell. Yeah. I'll tell whatever. But when it comes to, like, for whatever reason, it's just something I got that I need to work on. Like, in the interpersonal, like, I'll be upset about it, but I don't want to share it. But Katie's got made helped me get a lot better at it. I think I've gotten a lot better at it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I really do.
Okay. And Katie is perfect?
Yes.
In all her ways?
No, I'm not perfect. What do I do?
I'm not gonna. Hey, that's a saying. That's a setup. I called myself out.
Do you all have roles in the home? Katie, you're perfect.
We get that's actually we can tell. We, what are our roles in the home?
So I would say that one of our biggest trials was not when you got fired, because that was fairly.
It actually
easy.
Brought us super close
that
together.
Was super
it did.
Close. And just
that's
seeing
what I'm
all
talking
support,
about.
Yeah.
That thing, because out there were outside forces like trying to get your man, right? And mm-hmm. you were like, let's cleave together, right?
It's like 3 months after we got married, too.
Oh.
Yeah. Not
September,
yeah.
October, November, December, January. 5 months after
five
we
months,
got married.
Yeah. Okay. So it wasn't very long. And but just all the support and love that we received and was incredible. And we're both probably abnormally good at communicating with each other.
That's wonderful.
And it's super important.
That's the key.
100%.
And she's made me better
100%.
At it.
Oh,
but
that's
it is.
But you've made me better at it. Interpersonal communication.
Yeah.
Again.
Yeah.
So that is a question that I should have asked and I forgot, because I want other people to see what sustains a good relationship. And so you all saying
I will say communication.
Yeah.
It's interesting. Over anything else.
And I will add one thing to communication, which is humility, and not always thinking that you're right and that your position is
mm-hmm.
the way
yes.
to go.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking for me, but I think that is important. And I think that applies to everything. And Katie has not only made me a better person interpersonally, that's also made me a better activist, organizer, boss, whatever.
Yes.
For real.
This is wonderful.
Yeah.
Describe Katie in one magnificent.
Well, she got one and get her word too. Katie. If I had to describe Katie Morosky in one word, I would use the word, there's really two, so I need to narrow it down real quick.
Mix it. You know how we're mixing words like Ben Affleck and Jen?
Oh, Benifer.
Yeah.
We need to get one of those. Katike?
No, probably not.
Mighty? Gosh, that's a really tough thing to just ask somebody. I'm going to say stable.
Oh, I like it.
And it applies, many different.
Because when the boat is rocking.
Stable.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
Stability was the other one. And then there was another one, but I'll save it for later.
I like that.
Stable.
I like that.
My word for Mike is passionate. He doesn't do anything unless it's 100%.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And he does you 100%. Yay!
100.
It's so good.
But that makes sense. So the passion and stability, like, because passion without stability
is
turns into lunacy quite quickly.
Yes.
And stability without passion can get stale.
It's kinda,
But you put them both together.
And it's awesome.
It was good.
And powerful. You two are wonderful, magnificent. Here we go.
It's like we had
to
study for that.
And we have. Did you all introduce?
Biggie. You look
great. We have
great.
Biggie. They're part. He's part of the family.
That's Biggie.
And we also have Eddie the cat.
What is Eddie?
Eddie the cat is over
Eddie's
here.
Over here.
You might
just kind of hiding.
And then Alexis, who's
Alexis is
asleep.
Our 20-year-old.
A 20-year-old roommate. Yeah.
This is wonderful. Do you all have anything that you'd like to add? Do you have any special thing that you want to say to Katie, or any special thing that you'd like to say to Mike before we sign off?
So I love you very much.
I love you very much.
I love y'all very much.
We love you, Tanya.
Yes. So thank you all for joining us. You have the Morowskis. That's Morowski without a W. I've been using W for years. But Morowskis. And until next time, everyone, peace, love, and sugar.
Thanks, Tanya.
Yay.
Thanks, buddy.
Love you. Oh, that's so wonderful. Yay!